And now, a fireside chat with Arthur Bergeron.
Okay. Hi, and welcome to this fireside chat. My name is Art Bergeron. I'm an attorney at Myrick O'Connell. I do nothing but elder law. The purpose of these fireside chats is to acquaint you with, or to answer the specific questions that I often get from clients who are coming in to talk to me, and to supplement the broader issues that I usually talk about at seminars that I do at senior centers around this area. So I have structured this show as a call-in show. I'm always looking forward to calls, and I think I hear one coming in right now.
Mr. Bergeron, it's Frank again.
Frank, you've been calling a lot lately, right? How is Mary?
Unfortunately, Mary is not doing so well. We both really want her to stay at home, but I don't think I can do it without some help. Are there any government programs that can help me?
So, Frank, by the way, I'm sorry that Mary isn't doing well, and the issue that you raise is one that I hear a lot. I talk to spouses all the time who will tell me that they never want to leave their home, and that even if their wife is getting really sick, they really want to take care of them. There comes a point, though, where that becomes very, very difficult. I always tell my clients, I said, you know, if your wife is sick or your husband's sick, the last thing that you want to do is drop dead, because in that case, your spouse is going to be all alone and their alternatives are really going to be much more limited. So Frank, in your situation, if Mary is at home and you need some home care to take care of Mary, there is a significant federal program that may really help you take care of some of that care. The program is MassHealth, the Massachusetts name for the federal Medicaid program. And people are most familiar with MassHealth as a way of helping pay for nursing home care, because Medicare, the usual health insurance for seniors, will not pay for nursing home care for more than 100 days. What many people are not aware of, though, is that MassHealth, the MassHealth program, in an effort to keep folks who could otherwise avoid it from going to nursing homes, has developed a program called the Frail Elder Waiver. The purpose of the program is to allow you to stay home if it can be shown that you would otherwise need nursing home care, and that you could safely be at home as long as you get sufficient home care. So in order to qualify for this program, first of all, in order to qualify, you need to show that you are medically eligible. To be medically eligible, and in your case, Frank, for Mary to be medically eligible, she needs to show that either she needs regular assistance with at least two of the activities of daily living, which are eating, bathing, dressing, toileting, and transferring, or that she needs regular or constant supervision for her own health or for her own safety. Oftentimes, this qualification or this criterion is met for folks who have a disease that causes dementia, where the result of the disease is that the dementia is so severe that a senior may be not safe at home unless they have someone who is there all the time. So if your spouse meets either of those criteria, and therefore is medically eligible for MassHealth. And by the way, the group that determines whether you're medically eligible is the so-called ASAP, or Aging Services Access Point, in your area. So in the two areas where I work in central Massachusetts, that Aging Services Access Point is Baypath Elder Services. On Martha's Vineyard and Nantucket, where I do a lot of work, that Aging Services Access Point is Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands. If those folks have determined that you are medically eligible, and they'll make that determination after actually sending out a nurse to evaluate you, then you can qualify for up to, say, 40 or 50 hours of a week of home care, as long as you can show that you're financially eligible. Now, in the case of a couple, say Frank and Mary, if Mary can show that she has less than $2,000 in countable assets, she and Frank can be financially eligible, as long as Frank can show that he also meets certain financial criteria. Frank, though, can own the home itself as long as it has an equity of less than, Frank can own the home itself There was a criterion regarding equity, but no longer is. No matter what the value of the home, Frank can have other cash or cash equivalent assets equal to up to $123,600, and Frank can have unlimited income. So my advice to Frank in this situation, if he wanted Mary to qualify for MassHealth, would be to have Mary shift all of her assets to Frank and then have Frank restructure the assets to the extent that he needs to. Remember, he can own the home no matter what the value. If he has cash or cash equivalent assets, especially as a result of that restructuring, of more than $123,600, then he can reduce those assets by purchasing an annuity. As long as that annuity calls for equal monthly payments over a term that is shorter than Frank's actuarial life expectancy, then the purchase of that annuity or those annuities in any amount is a legitimate conversion from a countable asset to a non-countable income stream. The day after Frank makes those purchases, thereby reducing his countable assets below $123,600, Mary can qualify for the frail elder waiver. Now, once Frank has made those shifts so that he and Mary can qualify for MassHealth, he needs to apply for MassHealth and demonstrate that all of that has happened. Once MassHealth has determined that they are financially as well as medically eligible, they'll notify Frank and Mary. At that point, BayPath or Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands will send a person back to their home again to determine how many hours of care Mary would qualify for. As I mentioned, typically the Elder Services or the Aging Services Access Point will qualify that person for as much as 40 to 50 hours worth of home care. Once that qualification has occurred, then Frank would be able to hire agencies that are eligible and have contracted with the Aging Services Access Point to provide for that care. So there are a lot, and now one of the things that is important about this program, as opposed to MassHealth that is meant to qualify you for nursing home eligibility, is the program is not retroactive. You cannot, once you've been qualified for MassHealth, get coverage for care that you've otherwise been paying for during the period that you've been applying. Therefore, it's really important if you want to qualify for these programs that as soon as you realize that your spouse needs help, you start taking the necessary steps to become financially eligible, then apply for MassHealth, get MassHealth to qualify you, and then have the person from the Aging Services Access Point come back to your home to determine how many hours of care you may be eligible for. To do all of that, you probably want to talk to an elder law attorney, as well as to perhaps a geriatric care manager who can help you figure out all of this. But the theme of this, and what I really want you to take away from it, is there are programs that are available to you and for which you may very well qualify, which will allow you to stay at home as opposed to going to a nursing home. I hope this has been helpful for you in terms of thinking about those programs, and I look forward to talking to you in other Fireside Chats.